just sitting out. Look at that.
Look at that tank.
Wow.
Get him in here, bud.
I'll tell you what.
Now you were just sitting there.
You know, it just goes to show you, as I was mentioning, the bigger ones are sitting down inside the weeds. And you know what? This is what we're after here today. Hi, and welcome to the show. I'm Leo Stackles.
I'm Rod James.
And I'm Grant Mills.
And we are sitting in the beautiful town of Tweed right here with our good friend Jeff, the master of disasters. Put us on fish every single time we've gone out here.
Oh, yeah.
And we are just going to have a blast. Look at that.
What?
You know what?
That is a tank.
I'm going to keep this for some pictures afterwards. What do you think?
Yeah, you know what? I'd love to get some pictures.
And you know what else I'm going to do?
No, you're not.
Hang up my lines with you guys more often, because every time I sit on the bottom there, we get the bigger ones. All right.
You got them on that trigger X, eh?
Yeah, just pounding them.
Toyota presents Fish TV in high definition. Brought to you by Mercury, Cabela's, world's foremost outfitter, and Rapala, crafted from experience. With your host, Leo Stocco, and Ron James.
All right, let's try that again. I can let it sit there again.
You know what's funny about this area?
That there's lots of fish in it?
There's tons of fish. Well, there's 5,000 lakes in Land O'Lakes, but Stoco Lake is known for its musky fishing. I mean, there's nothing to catch, you know, fish over 50 inches here.
Well, you remember when we were first pulling in, we first launched the boat, and I said, look at that over there. There was a huge musky that just was corralling these crappie. That's another indication that you know you're in the right area when you see that.
There you go.
Crappie.
All right, buddy.
Craponia.
Nice
hot one, man. Little Stoco Lake.
Craponia. Oh, that looks
like a tanker. He rifled it.
You guys are using. Oh, that's a nice one, bud. Oh, look at that. Oh.
That's a beast.
You know what? I want to keep a couple for Shoreline.
Yeah, take some pictures.
Let's go a couple in the live well, Grant.
Yeah.
Oh, Jeffrey's on him now. Jeffrey's on him. Looks like our guy Jeff has done it again. I don't know what this guy must eat, sleep, and dream about where these fish are in the morning, because every time we go out with Jeff, this is exactly what happens.
Got a good one, Jeff?
Good one.
Oh, nice buddy.
One. Nice one.
Nice. That's a nice one he's got. What's happening here is that we're fishing. Our boat's in like six and a half feet of water. There's a ledge right here and it drops off, and I think these fish are just staging up before they come in here and spawn.
It's popping right off the bottom there, ain't it?
You and your largemouth, bud.
Yeah.
Hold on.
What is that?
Either a good crappie or another little largemouth.
Large.
Yes, it's a tank crappie, bud.
Tank.
Woo-hoo. Look at the size of this thing, bud. Look at the size of this.
That's a moose.
Look at this.
Oh, wow.
That's what we're looking for right there.
Look at the depth of the body.
Yeah, look at the back of it.
Yeah, big hump on him.
A couple of fillets on that. There goes Jeffrey. That's a tank right there. Look at that.
Oh, look at the size of that one.
That is a nice fish right there, bud. Look at that. How are we supposed to break in the mercury when the fish are right at the boat launch in Tweed? You literally don't even have to start the big motor. We are launched in Tweed. As you can see behind us, there's all kinds of buildings and stuff.
And as you can see in front of you, there's all kinds of fish.
And right over there is the boat launch. So, I mean, you could come out here in a little 14-foot Lund, or a 12-foot even, and just sit here and anchor and just whack them, just like that.
That one grabbed it as it was falling.
Now what we're fishing is, I think I mentioned earlier, is the first break. We're in like 7 feet of water, and it drops down to 10. That's got to be a bass.
Oh, I don't know, bud.
No, that is a tank.
That's a tank.
Oh,
what I was looking for. Swing him in the boat.
Look at the size of that thing. Oh,
that's what I'm talking about.
I've got one, you got
one.
Look
at that.
That is a, now that's a Land O'Lakes crappie.
That's a Land O'Lakes crappie right there, folks.
Well, I'll tell you, when Jeff called us, he said, you better get out of here because I'm catching tanks.
What? And you know what the good part is? Again, nobody here. Nobody here. Jeffrey, I don't know how you find these fish, dude, but you do it every time. Great under the boat. Crappies like lungs, just like I do. Look at the colors on it. These are black
patches. Look at the blue, iridescent blue on the tail.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, you got more on your tail. Yeah. I got a bit too, eh?
Great.
Yeah, beautiful fish, though.
Oh, they're gorgeous.
Beautiful. Oh, there's a thin one. Triplets.
I don't know where that one came from, but I think you're flying now.
That's flying.
Oh, there he is. Oh, you just ate him. Nice.
One after the other, after the other.
Nice.
Brother from another mother.
Oh, bud.
Look at this one.
Oh, my.
There's a tanker.
Oh, my. Look at the size of this one, bud. Look at this. Oh, my. Look at this. You got to see the size of this fish. My foot is a size 12. He's a solid 13-incher, anyway, maybe more. Nice big back shoulders on that thing right there. That's a beautiful crappie right there.
I felt that one tick.
Oh, look at the size of this one, too.
Another tank.
They're coming off the bottom. That's a 12 and a half, 13 there.
He just ate
another one run.
Oh, this can't be a crappie. This has got to be a bass.
Unbelievable. This thing took it down so far.
Yeah. Oh, it's a little pike.
It's a pike. What have I got it? I got a little sunfish.
We got a pike, we got a crappie,
and a little sunfish.
Just a beautiful
sunfish.
Look at this.
Another Land O'Lakes crappie.
We have double headers, triple headers.
Look at this.
This is ridiculous. Look at that.
Oh, it's a bass.
Oh, it's a bass.
Okay, so now we got a bass.
A pike.
Sunfish, crappie.
All in one area.
And a walleye.
All in one area.
All in one area. Oh, it's like the school just came back a little bit.
Yeah.
Like we're in a little bit shallower water now.
I think they're on the afternoon munch.
I think with this wind blowing in here, we just moved off and we're back into 6-7 feet. And it's blowing the bait in a little tighter, yeah. So I think they're coming back into feed.
Oh man.
Look at the size of that
right
thing.
By the boat.
What is that?
I think it's a bass.
No, it's not a bass, it's a crappie.
Oh, it's a crappie.
It's a crappie.
Oh,
look at the size of that.
I'm lipping this one. Oh, what a brute.
What is that?
That's a Land O'Lakes crappie there, folks.
Oh, yeah, that's got some shoulders on it. Look at the back on that thing, bud.
The big hump on him.
Holy.
Whoo. I gotta love it.
It's time for the Old Milwaukee Tip of the Week.
Hey folks, Leo Stockos here with the tip of the week. Guess what guys, Milwaukee has done it once again. You know, they originally introduced the Milwaukee heated jacket, which is absolutely incredible for those cold mornings and working outdoors. Well, guess what? Now they've brought out a mid-layer in a hoodie style, which not only is fashionable, but acts as a great mid-layer to put underneath that jacket or to wear on just on its own.
Well, you know what? I'm really excited because, you know, on those sunny days when you're ice fishing and you've got that warm sun, this can keep your body, you don't need that heavy coat. This will keep you nice and warm.
Well, the good news is, on those cold mornings when it's minus 30 below and the wind chill factor is minus 40, it actually acts as a great mid-layer underneath there. Stay tuned, guys, because Milwaukee's got some more new cool products coming out here. And the best part about it all uses the same red lithium technology. So the same battery you have for your drill is going to be the same one for your clothing.
I'm excited.
I'm going to try that same type of technique that I've been doing. All I'm doing is I'm pulling up forward a little bit and I'm casting out and then just letting the bait drag back with the wind. And it seems to be picking up the bigger fish that are lazy and sitting in those weeds for some reason.
Okay,
so
I'm coming up there.
Try that again. You come up here, Ronnie.
Okay.
Let's try that again and see if I'm actually telling the truth or it's just a coincidence. Let it drift back a bit.
Just like that.
As I was saying, I'm letting it drift back. Almost like I know what I'm doing. But you know what? It's not me. It's actually the fish. The fish are telling me what they want. They're not looking for a real aggressive presentation right now. They just want to kind of drift it over top the weeds. And it seems to be working right now. So as long as it keeps working, I'm going to keep doing it.
Yep.
Look at it. Look how far down it took it when I saw mm-hmm. the line tick.
Oh, I think I caught his brother.
And I think, I just missed his sister. Well, I think Millsy's got the competition sewed up there. Unless this one is a crappie, and it is. Look at the size of this one.
Another tank.
Still not as big as the one Grant got.
Oh.
Still a nice one, though.
Okay, come on. We got to get a triple hitter now.
Come on, Leo.
There we go.
There we go.
Yeah. Oh, bud, look at this. Dude.
Look at another this one nice coming
one.
In.
Leo's got a good one, too.
Yeah, we got a quad. Jeff had one over there, too.
Oh, we got four fish going on one.
Okay, here. Now, this is for all the bells and whistles. Who's got the biggest one? Mine wins. Look at that. Oh, that's
nice,
a beauty
nice
right there.
Nice fish, Rod.
Yeah, that's a good one.
That's a lot of fun.
There's a tanker over there. Oh, yeah.
Oh, this one's a good one, too, bud.
You got a good one, too, Rod?
Oh, yeah. These things. Yeah.
Look at this. Millsy. Yours is a bigger than mine, but it's still a nice one.
Well, I don't know, bud. You got a good one.
Hold on. I'm still not out of the water yet. Oh. Wait.
Look at this.
How's that for a pair of matching bookends, eh, Ron? Hey, what do you think?
Nice. Oh.
Missed it on that triple
header. On three, the crowd goes, oh. You know what? They're going in the box.
These are going in the box? These are dinner?
You want to put mine in there for me?
I will do that
for you, I'll get on the trolling motor. Thank you, sir.
Get us back in the sweet spot, Ron.
Portions of Fish TV are brought to you by Toyota and Sylvania Silver Star. See farther, see wider, see better.
There's the Millsy.
Ooh, nice one. There's a Land O'Lake crappie right there. Oh yeah, there's a tanker.
Oh, nice crappie.
Nice tanker, bud. He's hooked good. He's coming in, coming in. What awesome action we got here today, guys. I'm happy, 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 cause I'm catching crappie, crappie, crappie.
Look at the size of that guy.
Piggy poo.
Wow.
Another Stoco Lake giant.
Look at the size of that. Bud, you are on fire today.
Like, it's one thing to get a few big fish. It's another thing to get one after the other.
Beautiful, bud.
Nice. Nice Land O'Lakes crappies. Can't beat them.
Look at another monster.
Yellow. Yellow, this guy.
Yeah, that's a yellow one.
Another nice Land O'Lakes crappie.
You say that one more time.
Wow. Another nice Land O'Lakes crappie.
Oh, don't say it again.
Say it one more time.
Man, that's another beauty right there, eh?
Land O'Lakes?
Land O'Lakes crappie.
Oh, Millsy. You're funny.
Oh, here we go, boys.
He got pounded as well.
Oh, this guy drove it.
Did he?
Oh, man.
Nice fish right there.
Not a huge one, but he drove it.
Hey, there's a triple header.
Triple header.
Look at the size of all these fish.
Look at
them all.
Yeah, that's a tank.
Look at these fish.
That's a tank, bud.
That is just ridiculous, folks.
What a cow.
I got one. Grant's got one. Ron's got one.
Yeah.
Look at this.
And we got the folks with Tweed honking at us.
I mean, most people wave, we just go like this.
We just hold up the crappie.
Wow. Hold us on that spot, Ron. This is beautiful.
Okay. I'm gonna let them all go.
Back in the water. There we go. That is ridiculous.
Well, while these guys are fooling around, what I want you to do after the show is go to our website, fishtv.tv. You'll check out Jeff and look him up, hookedforlife.ca, and our Facebook and Twitter. Follow us every time we're in the Land O'Lakes area, and you're gonna catch fish just like I got one on right now. Look at this, another tank. Every time I talk to you folks, I get another fish. Just stay with me all day.
It's time now for the Motor Guy Tackle Box.
Okay, guys, let's take a minute out of the action and show you exactly what we're using today. I got my good buddy, Jeff Chisholm from hookedforlife.ca.
Yes.
Put us on these great crappies, buddy. what a setup and what a great day we had.
We've just had a great day. Caught a lot of fish, some big fish.
Some huge,
it's been awesome.
Huge fish,
a lot
like
of fun.
16 inches.
Yes, and we have some great products we've been catching these fish on. We've got
okay, let's
minnows,
see what we've got.
Cranks.
What it's were you catching them on?
Well, we've caught them on cranks. Rapala's got the ultralight series. This one here is the ultralight crank. And we also have the ultralight minnow.
Yeah, that thing worked great.
This is the yellow perch. We found out these fish are feeding on perch.
Yes.
So why not match the hatch? This is a slow sinking lure. Put a couple of split shot. We're fishing 6 to 8 feet of water. You got to get that bait down to where those fish are at and they eat it.
And your rod and reel.
Yes.
A little bit different than mine, but same company.
This is the Rapala F2 series, ultralight 7'2". Awesome rod for casting those cranks. Also for fishing jigs, minnows, and so forth.
Shift reel.
Shift reel. I've got Suffix fluorocarbon on there.
Yeah.
This is the ultralight shift reel. Perfect match combo for ultralight sensitivity. Fighting these fish in a rod that loads up, it's great.
Now I'm using a little bit different gear. I'm using the same classic trout rod with the Rapala. The RTS, beautiful reel. Now I've got the braid line. I've used the Suffix 832 braid, 10 pound braided line. Absolutely fantastic to feel all those fish. And it was tipped with the Suffix fluorocarbon. Leader, you can't beat it. You need that fluorocarbon in clear water.
Definitely.
Also, nothing but the best. Trigger X baits.
That's it.
They're the kicker.
That was the money bait.
That's the money bait right there.
You know, smaller stuff wasn't doing it. You moved to this 3-inch minnow, fish are eating it, and the big fish.
Hey, they're all big fish. I'll tell you what, folks, bring this stuff up to Tweed, catch yourself some great, great crappies, bring all this gear, and you'll have a lot of fun, just like we are.
For sure.
Take care.
This is a good one.
Come on over in here. Is that a, oh, it is too.
Look at the size of these things.
What are you doing?
I'm telling you, he's doing something different.
I know, he's popping. I'm watching him pop it. He's just popping it like this. What are you doing?
What am I doing? I'm just popping it like you said. Oh, he's got a scar on him, that one, a little bit. Somebody's tried to take a chunk of him. Boy, just, oh, man, I can't believe this place.
Oh,
this is unreal. You know, when you said you're gonna move here,
yeah.
I might move with you. I don't know, man.
I know
what I'm saying. I'm staying at Trudeau Park.
Place like this, full of crappies and big crappies, wow. It's magical. I think we'll put that guy back.
Yeah.
Let him
spawn. Got enough to eat, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm watch what he does.
Everybody's watching him. He's not going to show us.
He's hiding it.
Got a good one too, though, bud. Nice.
Look at that. Put a few of them in the box. There's that triple header we were looking for.
Yeah.
Not a good one, though.
No, I'm gonna let this one go.
All right, I'll throw this one in. Coming to you. Whoa. Oh yeah.
Better one.
Every single cast.
I know. Crazy.
Oh, he pegged it that one. Oh, this is a good one, brother.
Is it?
If this is a crappie, this is a good one.
It is.
Oh, it's a. Oh, it's a brute. Boy, I'll tell you, folks.
Holy.
These big crappies here out in Land O'Lakes. Man, I'll tell you that one. He just hammered that little bait there.
We're still hammering.
And
holy.
There's the result. Look at that. What a beautiful crappie.
Look at this one. Oh, another tank.
Not another big one.
Yeah.
Look at this. Leo's got one too. Get
this.
That guy in here, brother.
Oh.
Wow.
Look at that one, bud.
I'll tell you what, man. I cannot wait to get some pictures with these fish, Grant. We're going to let these guys recoup a little bit in the live well.
Yeah.
That is just beauty.
That's good a nice job. One, bud.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I got one, too.
Nice.
Just sitting there. Oh, bud, look at this one, too. Look at this.
Never mind, look at this.
Bookends.
I don't think so.
Whoa.
Oh, yeah, it was a little bit bigger.
Nice.
Look at the size of mine. Come on, Grant. We need a triple hitter. There you go. Get some cousins.
There we go, another tank. Just in the town of Tweed. Another boat coming out now. He's gonna...
Where are we, Grant?
Land O' Lakes.
Land O' Lakes. The town of Tweed, catching giant crappies.
You know what the good thing is, Ron? When we're done this, we get to go back and relax a little bit, have some dinner over at Trudeau Park, and maybe play a game of pool.
This is a big one, boys.
Oh, I got one too, Ron.
This is a good one. Look at
this. Two giant crappies.
Look at the bookends. Look at the size of those things.
Both of them. That's 13. This has got to be 14 or 15. That's just huge.
Couple of brutes.
A wide there.
Wow.
Look at that.
Funny, you set the hook, and then Grant set the hook.
Oh, nice. Tweed, Stoco Lake, and the Land O' Lakes area. We got to get over.
Well, don't forget that crankbait sinks, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, he's got a good one. Just pounded her.
Large one. No, it's a crappie, bud.
Oh, it's a nice crappie. There we go. And I got one too. Just sitting there. I love it when they take that line, here, huh? There you go.
Oh, nice.
I got the little brother. You got the papa.
Another slab.
Yeah, that's a nice one.
Hey.
Beauty.
Why's that beauty?
That is a nice one, buddy.
Yeah. Jump it?
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Jumped it. Look at that.
Okay, well, guess what?
Look at that.
I feel like cleaning a few of these. I'm getting hungry, are you?
Well, no, you know, I'm actually getting tired. I gotta be honest with you folks. You know, today, I actually had to fish under broken conditions. I actually spent the morning in Emerge because of a sciatic nerve problem. So I've actually been doing my best to entertain you folks. These guys have been entertained, laughing at me the whole time.
Oh, yeah.
But I gotta tell you, you gotta get out here, Land O' Lakes. Give our good buddy Jeff a call. He will put you on these fish, whether it's crappie, you saw it, crappie, lake trout, smallmouth, largemouth.
Hookforlife.ca. It's going to be on our website, so
it's
go there.
Pretty good. You know what, Grant, you are a superstar today, buddy. You did a good job on that trolling motor.
Well, I've had fun.
Guys, get out here to the Land O' Lakes region. You're going to have a blast just like we are. I'm Neil Stackles.
I'm Ron James.
And I'm Grant Mills.
We'll see you next time on Fish TV.
Bye-bye,
right here
everyone.
In Land O' Lakes.
Bye-bye.
Fish TV has been brought to you by Old Milwaukee. It doesn't get any better than this. Lund, the ultimate fishing experience. And your Ontario Toyota dealers. Real people, great cars.
Wait a minute. This calls for a open crappie style.